Pop said he thought Philly's defensive pressure kind of got to you guys as overtime wore on. Is that sort of your takeaway from it as well?
Yeah, I mean, I have to agree with him. Their intensity definitely picked up in the second overtime especially. And I think that we could have handled it better, for sure.
Have you ever been bitten during the game before?
Nah, it's a first for me. First for me. Especially by teammates, it's a first.
Can you explain his game plan there? Like, what was he trying to do there?
I don't know, man. I think he wanted that three. So he kind of got a little mad at me and bit me. But nah, I mean, everybody knows Keldon, man. He's super energetic. It's definitely an accident. But he's going to have to close his mouth around me from now on.
Well, good luck with that.
I know. I'll just stay away from him.
Losing Keldon there at the end, I mean, it seemed like that really hurt y'all, his energy and his...
Yeah, man. I mean, Keldon's he's a one-of-a-kind player for me. I mean, to this team, at least. You know, he's the heart and soul of his team. He brings a lot of energy. Regardless if he's scoring or not, his presence is definitely felt on both ends of the floor, you know. So losing him, it definitely hurt us. I mean, we were able to stick in, so credit to the guys who came in and replaced and, you know, stepped up. But, you know, it always hurts to lose somebody.
Even though it was like hours ago, but at the end of one of those, it was regulation, the first overtime, Victor trusts you to hit the shot to basically win the game.
Yeah, I mean, I've been saying this all year long to anybody who's asked me. He's a super willing passer. As good as he is on offense and putting the ball in the basket, he's 7'5". He's very aware that he attracts a lot of attention, and has no problem trusting his teammates to make open shots and make big shots. You know, so that's what you got to see out there, is just him being an unselfish player.
What is the confidence level in yourself that he's willing to hit you with that pass in the big moments?
Yeah, I mean, I'm confident in it. You know, I mean, everybody tells everybody the same thing. You open, you got to shoot it. And in a time like that, you know, I think we were down one or two. As soon as he kind of lobbed it to me, touched past it, there was no doubt in my mind. I was like, I got to shoot it. If I don't shoot it, I ain't getting the ball back. So shoot it. And yeah.
Going back to Kellen, do you feel just sort of bad for him that, you know, he's fighting back from injury and then seems to re-aggravate it?
Yeah, man. I mean, it's tough. I mean, I would know. Twist my ankle, not gonna work. I didn't retwist mine, but it's rough. So it's an annoying injury. Hopefully it's not the worst. I don't know what the results were with his stuff, but it's just annoying. It's just nagging. But he'll be okay. Got a whole off season. Lucky for him, you know, the season's coming to an end. It's winding down, so he'll have the whole off season to just rehab and get better and take care of it and be ready for next season.
What have you seen from Keldon? Essentially, you know, kind of switch places. Not directly,
yeah.
But you're in the starting lineup, and he started coming off the bench a long time ago. What have you seen from him changing those roles and the way he accepted it?
I think he's, well, one, I mean, he's obviously very aggressive offensively and defensively. But, I mean, I think since we kind of flip-flopped, he's just taken on the role of, you know, just being a great teammate, you know, obviously shooting his shots, playing hard, and kind of helping that second unit have that offensive burst. I think he's taken that role on like a man, honestly. He's been really good at it all year. So credit to him for sure, because that's, I don't know what that's like being in his position, but he definitely did a really good job. Us teammates, you know, we look at him as that guy, so yeah.
Julian, you started your 55th game for the Spurs this season. Huh? It's pretty rare for an undrafted player. Huh? What does it say about like your progress you made all year?
I consider this my first year in the NBA, because last year I didn't really get too many opportunities throughout the whole year, so it's my first full year playing in the NBA. But like I said when I got here, I mean, I'm going to just do the little things. I'm going to be the in-between guy that could, you know, make a shot, play hard here, play hard there, defensively just play all game, and kind of just fit in where I have to fit in. You know, not do too much here, not do too much there, but do my job. So hopefully that sticks.
You guys go from here to Memphis. I don't know if you're aware, but it's been a long time since the Spurs have beaten the Grizzlies. What makes it so difficult to play against them, really, no matter who's in those jerseys for Memphis?
They play hard.
Yeah.
I think that's the common theme with every NBA team, is just that they play hard. And especially when guys are out. I mean, look at us. Guys are out, and we're in every game.
Yeah.
You know, we're not out here getting, you know. Like we're in every game, you know. So I think when guys are out, teams tend to just pick up because guys want opportunities.
Mm-hmm.
So that's what makes them a super, you know, scary team, especially now, is their main guys are out and guys are stepping up. So going in there. Hopefully, we know. Good one.
I think you had them down by 17 here the last time you played it. I mean, you feel like you guys are due one against them or anything like that?
I think we are. I think we're due one for a lot of teams. for a lot of teams, but for sure. I think we got 4 games left now, 4 or 5, whatever it is. And I know our goal is just to win 4. The next whatever games we have, try to win them. You know, so, yeah.